Hey guys, in this tutorial I'm going to show you how you can create animated materials by using three different techniques. The first one is to use built-in textures in material node to create slight wind effect in puddle material. Second one is about how you can use particle systems to generate some textures that can later be used in materials. And in third one, using some textures and alpha textures to create matrix look, which is like falling numbers or letters. First, you will need to set up material node, which I have already told in my previous tutorials. So check it out and I will post a link in the top right corner. To create the wind effect in the water material node, first slide the black color of the color picker to make it fully reflective. Then press Shift A and search for the bump node and then add built-in texture known as Musgrave texture. And then add a mapping node. After that, just plug the texture coordinate to mapping, then mapping to Musgrave texture and Musgrave texture to height slot of the bump node and bump node to the normal. Then change the distance value of the bump node to 0.01 and increase the scale value of Musgrave texture to make water flow bigger or smaller. You can play with the X and Y mapping value to change the direction of the water flow. To see it in animation, you will need to insert keyframe. Make sure your current frame is on 0. After that, just right click X or Y location of the mapping node depending on which axis you want to move it and insert keyframe. Then change the current frame to the final frame and change the value to 0.2 and then right click value and insert keyframe. To generate texture and create a ripple effect from particles, take a plane and press W in edit mode to subdivide it up to 70. Then subdivide it one more time. Then add a plane position on the top of the plane and scale it down slightly. After that, add sphere to the scene. Then go to the Particles tab after selecting the upper plane and under the Render tab, select the Render as Object. Then select the picker and select the sphere. Then hit Spacebar and adjust the scale of the particles under Render tab. After that, just change the number of emission to 20 to generate less particles. Then go to the Physics tab and select Dynamic Paint and change the type to Brush and then add Brush. Then change the source to Particle System and select Particle Setting under Particle System. Then select the lower plane and in similar way add Dynamic Paint to it. Under the Dynamic Paint tab, change the type to Canvas. After that, change the surface type to Waves. And now if you hit the spacebar, you will get a ripple effect caused by particles. You can also smooth the mesh from the Object tab of the mesh. Now change the value of the time scale to 0.40 and speed to 3.94. And damping, which is used to clip down the ripples from getting far to edges of the mesh, make it 0.60. Spring to 0.20 to make spring effect in the ripples and smoothness to 0.10. Then hit spacebar to see how it's looking. And go to the shading tab and to have proper look at it, apply a material to it with 0 roughness and 1 metallic value. And play the animation, you will see some cool ripples. Don't hesitate to play with the values of the waves. You will always learn with some experimentation. If your ripples are going towards the edges, scale your particle plane small. Now to create material to have normal map of this, duplicate the material output and add an emissive material to it. And then add image texture. The texture I'm using, you can get it under the description box. You can download it from that link. Add mapping node, select texture in it and apply 2 value to X, Y and 0 to Z scale. Then 1 to X, Y location. Then add vector transform and select normal in it. And change the world to object and object to camera. Then add texture coordinate and connect normal to vector transform and connect all of them. Now go to the top orthographic view and make sure your cursor is in the middle of the plane. Then add camera. Under the camera settings, change it to orthographic and change the orthographic scale value to 2. Then go to the scene tab and change the resolution to 2048 by 2048 or 4K or 1K. You can define the path where you want to have the texture to be saved. It will be present under the scene tab. After that, make sure you are in Cycles engine to render it out. And to hide the other things from being rendered, just apply a transparent material to them. You will need to bake the animation on the plane so that you can easily render out the texture images. So just go to the physics tab and under the dynamic paint tab, there will be a cache tab. Just hit the bake all dynamic to bake animation. Now you just need to go to the render tab and hit the render animation. To make sure how it looks, take a plane, apply material to it with full roughness and metalness to see render result. After that, just search image texture and select all the images and open them. Then search for normal map node and plug that and make sure you check auto refresh and cyclic. Now if you hit spacebar, you will see the material animation. You can even use the program Gluid to even import the texture to Unreal Engine. To create the matrix effect, I have used 3 textures. One is the base color texture and the other 2 are simple drops that I've made in Photoshop. For the material, use emissive and plug the base color texture in emissive. Then add mix shader before material output. and use the alpha 1 texture and put it into the mix shader second slot to see how it's covering the letters. But you will need to put it in the mix shader factor, so plug it in the factor slot. After that, add transparent shader in the second slot of the mix shader. Then add invert after the alpha texture, because I have made the raindrops white color and it needs to be black so that it can mask the base color letters. Now just add another mix shader and duplicate this whole node system to mix both node system. After that, make sure you use the replace the alpha texture with the second alpha texture in the mix shader of the second node system. Then add texture coordinate and mapping node individually to both node texture alphas. To animate the texture, you will need to set keyframe and make sure in which direction you want the letters to fall. Change the location value of mapping node to see in which axis they are falling. In my case, I need to use Y axis with 0 value or 1 value and right click the value and set the keyframe. Then go to the end animation frame and change the value to 2 and again insert keyframe. Then hit spacebar to see how it works. It's only previewing on some letter, so you need to apply same keyframe procedure to other alpha. After that, duplicate the mapping node and texture coordinate and plug that into the alpha texture too. Make sure you are at 0 keyframe and put 0.2 value and insert keyframe inside mapping node. Then go to the end animation frame and apply 2 value on mapping node keyframe. In the end, I just increase the bloom intensity and increase the value of emission to make it glow. And that's pretty much about it. Hope you have learned new tips and tricks. If you like my tutorial, then support me on Patreon, where you will be able to download the project files that I have used in my tutorials. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and thanks for watching.